Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe. Today I'm going to show you how to update Photoshop CC to the latest version, which is CC 2017. I'm also going to show you how to copy all your plugins over. And this will work pretty much for any update of Photoshop. So what we're going to do is go to Creative Cloud. Now, if you don't see the latest version right there, just go under the icon. And then just go down and choose app updates and update your app. But right now we see that Photoshop CC 2017 is ready to go. So I'm just going to click update. Type in my password. And go. Now one of the things you need to be aware of is 2017 is actually going to replace Photoshop CC 2015.5. So when you just get the incremental updates from time to time, all they do is they just drop new features in an update. But when we do a full version, such as a 2016 or a 2015 or 2017 in this case, it's going to completely replace that version of Photoshop. Okay, this has now been downloaded. And if you look under here, you'll now say open. So let me click on open. And what it's going to do now is it's going to open Photoshop. Okay, so here we go. There's our Photoshop. And if we go down the bottom here, you'll see that it's playing right there. But there's my old version. It's 2015. Now, if I turn on 2015.5, in my case, it's still there. Okay, so here we are. We're now running Adobe Photoshop CC 2017. Now, one of the things you'll find is if you go under Filter, all your third-party plugins are missing. All right, let's fix that. So what we're going to do is we're going to quit Photoshop CC right now. And then we're going to go under the drive where we have these installed. You're going to go to the Applications folder. I'm just going to open this up a little bit so we can see. So here's our Applications folder right there. And you'll see there's Photoshop CC 2017. Now, if I double click that, it's going to open up. And one of the things you're going to see is there's a folder that says plugins. Now, if we click on this plugins, it just shows generator. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to control or command click, and that's going to open it in a new tab. Okay, so here we are in 2017. Let me go back to applications here, and we can look at the earlier version. So here's a 2015.5. I'm going to control click and open that in a new window. We're also going to go back here. Let's open up 2015 as well. Okay. So let's go to our plugins folder for 2017, and I'm going to move this tab to a new window. So here's our tab there. We've got nothing in it really. Let's go to our 15.5, go to plugins, and we'll see we've got our Google. So that's our Nik plugins. So we're just going to drag those over, hit authenticate. And that'll be our Nik filters. Let's go to our previous version, see what else we've got in here. I've got Particle Shop here, and I've got some other filters, so let's just drag those over. Let's choose New. We'll just create a new file here. And we're just going to go here. Let's just open a default Photoshop size, so there's really nothing in it. And if we look under the filters, now you can see there's all our different filters are now available. Particle Shop, Photomatics, all the different ones. They may require updating in some cases, but let's have a look and see if it works. So if we just grab here the Color Effects Pro 4. And there we go. So I hope you found this little tip useful. If you did and you want lots more tips like this and other tutorials on Photoshop, Lightroom, and different gadgets and stuff like that, don't forget to join the Cafe crew by hitting the subscribe button. Right now, become a subscriber. So thanks for watching, guys. Hit the like button, drop a comment, let me know you're watching, and until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.